Yo, what up, what up? It's your boy OJ, aka Coach Iwapa, and I'm here to deliver more fitness information to you. You must be interested in fitness or else you wouldn't click this video. So, I'm gonna go right into it, alright? So, you wanna build the ultimate beach body figure, right? You must have, because that's why you clicked this video. So, before I even get into the information, I want you to imagine what is the type of body that you wanna have, alright? What do you consider to be the ultimate beach body? Take the time to think about it. All right. Keep that in mind as I'm talking right now, because I want you to imagine that, and I want you to actually use this information and apply it to your workout regimen so you can get that body right there, all right? Let's do it. So, the first thing is first, you don't want to be working on one body part every day. This might sound like a straightforward information, simple, like obviously, but there's a lot of clients that I work with in the past that will only do legs every day, only work on their arms every day, only work on their chest every day. It may sound like it's absurd, but there's people out there doing that, and you don't want to do that. For one, your muscles need time to recover in between workouts, and two, you need to show your other parts of your body some love. You feel me? I know you guys seen those memes out there of the gym bro that only works on chest every day. I know you seen that, right? Yeah, I know you seen it. So I don't want that to be you. I don't want you to only work on legs every day. I don't want you to only work on arms every day. I want you to show love to every single part of your body. One. Two. I want you to be able to do different variations of the same exercise. Different variations of the same exercise. For example, all right, there's a chest press, right? Boom. Chest press. Yeah, it's cool. But it's also the incline chest press that's the top part of your muscles, all right? Not just overall chest, but the top part of your chest. Emphasizes the top part of the chest. I can't even talk right now. Then there's the decline, right? The decline chest press. Like, it's the lower part of your chest. You feel me? All those different parts recruit different muscle fibers or emphasize different areas of your body. And your whole muscle is made up of multiple muscle fibers, all right? They're made up of little muscle fibers. Alright, so if you can be able to affect every single part of the muscle, that's going to bring out the actual muscle shape, meaning you're going to look better that particular area of your body. You see what I'm saying? So if you're only doing chest press, like if you only focus on doing chest press, and you don't do no incline chest press or decline chest press, you're not going to bring out the full muscle, basically. You want to be able to bring out the full muscle by recruiting all the different muscle fibers in the different area of that particular muscle. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? I hope you see what I'm saying. So think about the body that you want. All right. Think about an area that you're struggling in. All right. That in your legs or your arms, your chest. All right. That's not really looking the way you wanted to look, and you've been working on it for a long time. All right. Have you switched up? Have you done every single possible exercise and at every single angle? All right. Do you only do squats and not sumo squats? And not donkey kicks, you see what I'm saying? Do you only do chest press with the chest press? I mean, on a flat bench, but not on an incline or a decline. Do you only do lat pull downs, you feel me, to work on your back, but you don't do pull ups, you don't do upright rows, you don't do deadlifts? You have to do different types of all the different exercises because they recruit different muscle fibers. You wanna bring out the full muscle. You want that beach body, right? I know you want that beach body. I want you to get that beach body. That's why I'm reminding you. You feel me? That's why I'm reminding you. I'm starting to get amped up because I love it. I really, really mean this. I'm really passionate about this message. That's the word I meant to say. I'm really passionate about this message because it's a simple mistake that you can change today. You feel me? Look at this bicep. I'm not trying to brag right now, but look at this bicep. How I built definition in this bicep. It's not by only doing a straight, a standing bicep. It's by doing preacher curls. You know what I'm saying? It's by doing hammer curls. It's all about building more definition for when I do my pull-ups. You see what I'm saying? There's multiple different exercises that I've done over time to build this bicep. It's not even perfected all the way. There's still different angles I gotta hit to bring out the muscle to the fullest of its ability. But I'm just giving you an example so you can visualize. I can paint the picture. You feel me? So keep in mind, you want to make sure you're doing all the different exercises for a particular body part. Not just one that you've been doing for the last 2-3 months. All right, switch it up. And last but not least, keep your body guessing. All right? Keep your body guessing with the workouts that you're doing. All right? After you're doing the same thing for a long time, your body's like, okay, I got this down. All right? I know she's about to do squats with the 45s. I already know that. I know she's going to do it for 8 reps. Yeah, I know that. I know he's going to do the incline chest press with the 25 dumbbell. I already know that. We've done this for the last 2 months. You want to keep your body guessing by switching, by finding something to change up that workout, whether it's adding more weight, whether it's adding more reps, whether it's adding more sets, whether it's changing the rest period in between the time that you rest, but whether it's adding another workout back to back, now you're double setting, adding another workout back to back to back where you're tri-setting, or putting a whole bunch of workouts back to back to back, so now you have a circuit training type of workout going on. You have to find something, you have to find ways to change up your workouts, all right? Your body wants to use the least amount of energy to do work. So if you can find a way to kind of tweak it up, you don't do anything too dramatic, even though the more dramatic, the better. But just find ways to switch it up. And if you can do those three simple things, not work on the same body part every day and not showing your other body part love, other body parts love, you want to make sure there's symmetry throughout your whole body. 2, doing different type of exercises, all right? Altering the exercises that you're doing for the particular body part. Not just doing one particular exercise or 2 particular exercises. Do all of them. They all provide benefits because they recruit different muscle fibers. By hitting a certain exercise in a different angle, you're recruiting more muscle fibers. The more muscle fibers you can recruit, the more that you can wear them out, boom, break them down, the more they build back up, and the more, you know, you build muscle, you feel me? But you want to hit it at all different angles, though, to make that muscle look more full, to look complete. See what I'm saying? And last but not least, keep your body guessing, because your body always wants to use the least amount of energy to do work. So when it starts getting used to your exercises, it's going to resist, and that's how you see, it's going to resist showing you results because it's used to it, you feel me? And that's how you see stalled progress, and you don't want to see stalled progress. You always want to keep on getting results. So keep your body guessing by switching up the workouts, adding more weight, reps, sets, less time between your rest. And yeah, I hope that helps. I'm going to get better. You guys get better. Let's get better together. It's OJ, and I'm checking out.